here we are, day two. Things looking pretty good for Australia. 4 for 321, going along quite nicely. And more importantly, we seem to have caused a little bit of a stir with the old cherry picker, and there's been a little bit of interest. We've done Radio 5 live, the sport there. We've done the photo shoot with Reuters today, and now the BBC have come on in to get a few shots. So we've become media personalities overnight.
We've got BBC, have just turned up to do an interview with us.
Yeah, and I'm here up with Andy.
No.
Just telling the folks
at home. We've got to do an interview with Reuters and with Radio Leeds. This guy brought a crane up here, and Greg got talking to him, and he's got in the ground today, so me and Greg are sort of up the top of this. We look down on everything. We're just like stuck up in the middle of the air, like in the middle of the ground, overlooking the ground. Really? Yeah, it's quite scary though. And Greg's off right here, and he's never ever used it before.
That's very true. This is my maiden Simon Kadich's first test match. It's the first time I've ever operated the cherry picker crane. And I've done not too badly.
Basically, they've got my mobile number. And they're going to call for it. One of them this afternoon. They hope they think, because we can only get two in at a time. I think one of them's hoping they're going to get the TV cameras this afternoon. It's fun, isn't it?
So there you go, the things that can happen.
Oh, yeah.
We'll pick this up a bit
later.
Yeah,
well, no, just about where we're from, and, you know, I'm lying, I'm telling the mum from Australia.
So a bit later in the day, 5 for 389, we've just done the Channel 5 interview. How do you think that went, Andy?
Very well on the whole. If anything, I would say that we are made for television, unquestionably.
Absolutely.
And so yeah, bring it all on, more interviews.
Are they still there, the film crews?
They are still there.
Let's just check them out. How much attention are we attracting here? There's
Christ, we've got a bloody mask next to this van.
Look at that.
Where did that come from?
I don't know. There's the old BBC van, and these guys having a bit of a look. Your journos, Channel 5 interviewer, the cameras.
Andrew Payne, P-A-Y-N-E. We're at the top of the crane at the moment. I'm from Queensland. Yep, okay.
Bit of bullshit goes a long way. Interview.
Not too bad, mate. Not too bad at all. Going well today. It's going well today.
Guffey's bowled pretty well.
I mean, if you hang on to the lunch break, that would obviously be better for us. But we've missed.
We're now scheduling our interviews much better around the cricket.
1 o'clock, basically.
Across Yorkshire, Lincolnshire and the North Midlands, this is BBC One with Look North, presented by Peter Levy.
An inquest opens into the deaths of two half-brothers shot dead in Lincoln.
And join me in North Derbyshire, where I'll be lucky enough to be on the pool with eight women at the same time. Fancy that! Come on, pull!
Push!
And a very good afternoon to you. Thank you for joining us. So welcome to Friday's Look North. First this lunchtime, hoax calls to South Yorkshire Ambulance Service are at an all-time high, according to figures released today. On one... Now, what lengths would you go to see a cricket match? Well, I'm sure you'll all be aware that there's a certain Ashes game going on at Headingley, and tickets have been sold out for months. So two Australian fans were so desperate to get a view of the match that they hired this crane, which has been set up at a Headingley B&B. They now have their own homemade version of the West Stand. And Greg Swedosh and Andy Payne join me now from their grandstand seat near Headingley. Gentlemen, good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon.
Good view at the moment?
Fantastic. Well,
magnificent view.
Well, you've certainly gone to some lengths. What gave you the idea for the crane?
Well, it was actually a guy who I met up here, Stuart Jeffrey, another Aussie, who he tried to get tickets over the internet and just found that they were unavailable.
So you thought the crane would be a good idea?
Absolutely, and thought that the crane in the B&B, it's the best view in the house.
The B&B happy?
Yeah, they thought he was a bit mad, I think, when he just said, can I park a crane in the car park and, you know, watch the cricket? So they were happy enough. I don't think they thought he was serious.
Yeah, well, there you are. Now, are there any problems with being perched so high up? I mean, you know, occasionally you'll need to take a comfort break, won't you?
Yeah, we had a few problems this morning as well, you know. We had quite a heavy night last night. And we were a bit wobbly on our feet getting up there this morning, so that was a bit shaky.
It was. But, yeah, toilet breaks and that, we come down. We do the right thing.
All right. Well, listen, yeah, do enjoy. Game going well?
Yeah, pretty well. Pretty well for Australia. Very nice morning. Damien Martin, 97 not out. Looking forward to seeing another Aussie ton.
Yeah, I reckon Warnie's good for this morning as well.
Well, you get a job as a commentator if you don't get too wobbly. Very good to talk to you, fellas. Anyway, from your grandstand position there.
Oh, Peter, there's just one thing. Peter Lever, you played for Lancashire, didn't you?
I did not. Thanks very much indeed.
All right.